guys, how's it going? Ivy Coops here, and today I'm bringing you a guide for the quest Monkey Madness. The items that you are going to need for this quest are a gold bar, a ball of wool, some monkey bones, or a monkey quartz if you start a Tie Boy 10 trio. We'll be obtaining that during the quest. The other items that I would recommend are some sort of poison cure, so I've got antidote plus plus, prayer potions, stamina potions, energy potions, some food, money, 200,000 if you don't, well, if you don't want to work out the puzzle, which we've just got to do in like a couple of minutes. Ring of Jordan as well, I would say, would be worthwhile just for ease of banking. So you just want to go to the Tree Known Stronghold. And you just want to go to the Grand Tree and you want to speak to King Narnode. A bit too far out. I didn't mean to do that. Oh, I hit an 18. Let's drop this. Let's speak to King Narnode. Yes. I'm going to be recording this by chapter at a time, just for making it a bit easier to record it for myself when I have to render it out. But all of the parts are still going to be in like one guide. So from here, you literally just want to climb all the way up. Go to Gandius, which is the Grand Tree by Karamjar. From here you just want to head west through this fence, and then you just want to head north up to this dockyard that we went to in the Grand Tree. But while we're here, you just want to kill a monkey. You cannot kill it using melee, so you're going to have to range it. Or mage it, you only have 6 health, but from there you just want to get your monkey bones or monkey corpse. Now you just want to head north up to the dockyard. You have to go through that dialogue and they won't let you in. From here you just want to come to this little back building to the south and you want to talk to GLO Karanok. So you just want to talk to him and then you just want to make your way back to King Nano, so you can literally just go back to the glider. I should have brought my potions with me. We'll do that in just a second before we get to the puzzle this far. So from here you just want to use the glider again. I'm not even going to try and pronounce that, that's stupid. Alright, so you just want to climb all the way back down. Let's talk to King Narnode. Thank you. get some orders, just carry on, guys. It just takes. So, from here on, you're just going to want to bring some items with you. I'm just going to, from now on, I'm just going to bring an antidote. Right, these can dote you down here for now. I'm going to bring one antidote, five prayer potions, a stamina potion, five super energies. I'll bring three prayer pots for now. Yeah, we'll do that. And then we'll bring 12 monkfish. We don't need the wood of gold for now. So now you just want to make your way to the first floor of the tree. You want to make your way over here and you'll find Dairo. You just want to speak to him. Go through every option. Yeah, it will blindfold you and it will take you to the underground base. Talk to him again and it will introduce you to Waydar. Just gonna turn that off. Right, so you wanna operate the reinitialization panel. We're gonna want to start sorting because OS body just sorts it for you. Okay, well, if you don't have OS body, I'm gonna teach you the logic behind it anyway. Basically, when you're sorting the puzzle out, you want to get these three pieces, 1, 2, and 3, three pieces here in the right order, and then when you get the fourth piece, you want to get it in the top right corner and the other piece underneath it, and then you literally just want to rotate it around, and then you just go along and do the same thing, and eventually when you get here, you'll get to the point where you literally just have this bit to move and you just rotate it around and it ends up sorting itself out.
I really hate these things. Also, if you really, really don't want to do it, you can go to where... I forgot what the guy's name is. Glau, that's the one. Yeah, if you really can't do it, you can go back to Glau's house and you can speak to Glau and you can pay him the 200k and then he will literally just sort it for you and it will be one piece out and all you've got to do is move the last piece and it will be done. But as you can see, by going through this, it's going in like the same kind of logic as what I told you. Well, I see it is not really. I think it's just decided to take like the longest way possible, to be honest. But I don't know. I think the way I was explaining it's actually quicker. I really hate sliding puzzles. I believe it messed itself up. I really shouldn't have followed this. This is stupid. I swear it jumped up from like 30 moves to 90 moves. Hey, finally, that took forever. So from here, you just want to talk to Deira again, and then speak to Waydar. So you want to speak to Lumdo? Say that he won't take orders from you, so you just have to speak to Waydar and get him to pull rank on Lumdo. Did that? Oh, it just cancelled out. Let's do that again. We just have to go through this little cutscene. I think it's because I clicked the X, I think. Right, so we're now at chapter 2. I'm just going to end it here and I'll pick it up at the start. Right guys, let's do chapter 2 of Monkey Madness. So now we are on the island of Ape Atoll. From now on, I would highly recommend drinking your antidote plus, just because all of the snakes and stuff in this jungle are poisonous, and I would also recommend having protect from missiles as a quick prayer, just because we're gonna need it. So from here you just want to head west. Ow. They hit more than I thought they was going to. You just want to keep heading up until you reach this bit here, and you want to activate pray from range. You'll be knocked unconscious. Here you want to deactivate your prayer. You want to speak to Lumo in this cell, and here are the other members of the 10th Guard. Now, the issue we have is we are in jail. So, as far as I remember, these gorillas go in shifts of 2, and then they patrol twice, and then they swap. I just want to double check what the pattern is before I attempt to do it, because I don't want to not end up taking ages. But I don't want to have to like go back for extra food or something, I don't know. I guess I'll just cut it if I have to do that. I should have gone then. I guess a higher thieving level here would be good. I don't know, well, it's probably going to take a while actually. A lockpick would be good too if you don't have one. Stamina potions running off already. You see, I got hit from there. Alright, he's gonna come back up here, and then when he walks off up there the next time, that's when we're gonna have to go. I want out. I want out. I don't even know if this is the right spot to hide. Yeah, this will do. Because they don't come any further as far as I'm aware. Ah, spider. You should be coming back down. This spider respawns so quick. Ah, I did that too early. No, I didn't. Yeah, I did. No, 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 I want out. Right. You just want to head north. You want to be really careful with them monkey archers as well, because they can actually knock you out. Alright, so from here, you literally just want to head into the grass. This guy's kind of like... There he is, invisible. You want to speak to Kram. Just speak. Just ask every option. So from here, you want to head south. The monkey archers shouldn't attack you while you're in grass, but you want to activate prayer for missiles just in case. You just want to head around the back here, and you want to speak to Garkor. Tell you to go find his squad mage. Right, now from here, you are going to want to run up and to the left. You want to reactivate protect from missiles, and you just want to go down under here into this, to the bottom of this house here. Well, this building, sorry, not house. When you're inside, you want to make sure you stay on the dark brown ground, or you will get sent back to the jail. The spiders inside are aggressive and poisonous, but the poison isn't too bad. But so, let's head up. So there's a sleeping monkey here. You don't want to wake him up, which is why you want to stay on the ground, on the dark brown ground. From here, you just want to head around and you want to search these crates. Search this crate here, make sure you stay on the dark brown ground, and you want to take spider, go away. Oh, you didn't even die from that, really. Right, and you want to take some of these monkey dentures. Use the southeastern crate and you want to drop that. Ah, oh, spider. gonna go down. As long as the spider doesn't affect. Oh, 15 damage. That wasn't nice. So from here, you want to head to the northwest side of the cave. Let's just start searching the crates again. Get this monkey amulet mold. Now from here, if you want to resupply, you can head back up to Ape Patrol, back through this building. You can head down here, jump across, and then you can just sail back. For me, I'm just going to teleport to Castle Wars real quick. Just going to drop all this off. I'm just going to bring fresh potions because so again, you want to bring. Oh, I've got my Annie poison. You want to bring all your set of potions, so Annie poison, stamina, super energy, prayer. You want to bring some more food. You also want to rebring the monkey dentures, the monkey amulet mold, the gold bar. Remember. Bottle bones. Bring the notes. And that's the whole inventory. Cool. Okay, from here we'll just go Edgeville. Probably should have just gone Edgeville first, to be honest. Travel back to the Tree Gnome Stronghold. So from here, you just want to make your way back up to Dairo, I don't know how it's pronounced, I'm really bad at pronunciations. Anyway, you just want to go to that guy on the first floor. But he now has a travel option if you right click him, so you can literally just do that and it just makes it a bit quicker. And you just want to travel on Wador. Now while we're here, you want to sail across. From here, you want to head west to make sure you drink Annie poison. And you just want to head west until you reach the exclamation mark. Find a bamboo ladder which you want to climb down.
here, we're gonna have to make a very long trek through a tunnel. I would highly recommend activating protect from melee through this. It's a pretty long tunnel, I hate doing it. You can cut parts of it out if you click the right places, which is pretty nice. There is a part where you actually have to run through a room that's got quite a few of them in, which we're coming up to. Well, there's more than one part, to be honest, and it's a multi-combat area as well, which isn't great. But as you can see, when you're a higher level, this is a great place to train. We're about 2/3 of the way through the cave. Go away, Leo. I didn't mean to swear, my bad. I'm really bad with it. We're almost there. Just about. So you just wanna come up and you wanna talk to Zoopnock. Ask him what we need for the two items. It doesn't matter because we've already got it all, but you know. Oh, I didn't turn my prayer off. Oh no. Whoops. But from here, you just want to use each of the items on Zoopnock. I'd say from here, now that you've got this enchanted bar here, you can give him the bonus just to free up space. I'd recommend banking now. Just for the fact, I'd recommend teleporting away and then just making your way back as well. Just for the fact of running through that cave is fucking long.
It's alright though. I think we're alright, to be honest, for I'm just gonna restock here real quick. Just gonna swap that for that, bring another one of them. I just want to travel with Lumdo again. Hey, you want? I already had that active. Whoops, my bad. Oh well. From here, you just want to run west again, back up to this bit where the bridge is, where you got shot by all the monkey archers and placed in jail. And we're gonna get placed in jail again. I really hate these things. So freaking annoying. Go away, spider. Thank you.
wanna run east again.
This is one of the bits I hate the most. Right, from here you wanna be using Brave. Protect melee. And you just wanna run in. You wanna be careful of these. Try going up the bamboo ladder if you can. Oh, I hate these things. You can't run through the ones with beards. Alright, so from here you just wanna go down. Yeah, open the trapdoor. Down the trapdoor. Use your enchanted bar on the wall of flame. And back up the rope. Now you want to get out of here. Anywhere you can. And then you want to run back up this way into the grass. Oh no, almost went too far. From here, you want to head back across. You can, from here, you can also use your ball of wool on that to make a monkey speak amulet, which you might want to equip. So now from here you want to be careful and you want to be keeping an eye out for the monkey's aunt. The first thing you want to do is make sure you have 5 empty spaces. As soon as she moves off. Speak to the monkey real quick. If she catches you, it's game over. Well, not game over. Well, I'll be a monkey's uncle. Speak to him again. She told. How many bananas did she want? She wants 20. There you go. I'll get them for you. I got scared because she got too close.
Now I'm just gonna have to wait for her to leave again. Oh.
But now we've given him 5 bananas, he should give us a talisman. As soon as she leaves.
She hasn't given him the toy yet. What? Okay.
Okay, so we've got to wait for her to come back around one more time for her to. Because I guess she's taking the bananas from him then, and now she's going to give him the toy when she comes back. I don't know. now we have a monkey talisman.
From here, you just want to head east again. We'll climb up this bamboo ladder here, quick. No. Nah, oh, I ain't doing this. I ain't doing the whole jail thing again. Not doing it. Nah. I'm just gonna buy a quick couple more glories. Yeah, from here, we literally just have to head all the way back through that long ass cave. Just speak to Zook, not Genk, because now we need to get him to make a talisman. Oh, we need to get him to make the monkey Gree-Gree even. We already gave him bones, so that's one of the two items we need. The other one we needed was this monkey talisman. That's why I said talisman earlier. I just got it a little bit wrong. I hate all these people which do like betting games and crap. Thank you.
At least we're getting there. I'd say we're about 2/3 of the way through the quest now.
Talisman, Kazook Knock. Now we've got a cutscene.
Right, chapter 3. From here, if you want to go bank, and that again you can, or you can literally, if the easiest way to, you don't even have to like, you can literally just run it back now, you won't get attacked if you use your monkey Grigory.
Here, I believe we don't actually need our prayer as much either, because we can literally stay in monkey form and won't get attacked by any of the other monkeys.
So from here we can literally just go back towards the village, but this time because we're a monkey we won't get sent to jail. Yeah. Make sure you've got your monkey speak amulet equipped as well.
game where Gargoyle was, I believe it was. You have to speak to him in monkey form too. Speak to the Elder God. And now you'll be told we need to speak to a guy called Kruk. Gonna make your way to the far west of the island, up this little bit here, and a little bit of crossover.
Oh, get out of my way, you bearded gorilla. At least it's easier to just run through the town now.
So we'll climb up this ladder, head across the bridge, and down the other ladder. I should have brought some more stamina potions. Oh well. And then you just want to speak to Kruk, which is the big beefy monkey. Level 149. If you don't have to walk back, we should teleport there. So now we're gonna go speak to the king monkey. And now we've been told that we need to free a monkey from our dome. Right, from here on I'd also say to just restock, ready for a fight. Don't need any of them anymore. Equip that. And then we'll get... Give me my necklace. What? What is that for? But if it's just the body. Yay! just want to head to Argo and head to the south to the zoo.
See, this is the part where it starts to get peak, guys. We're almost done with the quest, but this is probably the most annoying thing. Right, so now we're at the zoo. You want to re-equip your monkey Grigri. And you want to talk to the monkey Minder. And he'll put you in the cage. Now you're in the monkey cage, you want to find the monkey that says talk to. Make sure you have an empty space as well. So we now have a monkey. You wanna take on a group of Grigri and speak to the monkey minder again and he'll get you out. Now from here you wanna make your way all the way back to Ape Atoll. If you teleport, if you do any kind of teleport, even if it's like from a random event, the monkey's going to leave your inventory. So this means you've got to make your way all the way to the tree gnome stronghold, Baffert. Too far. Whoops. I don't even know what I'm doing. Want to head back up to Dairo on the first floor of the Grand Street. Thank you.
persuader. And then again with Lumdo.
And you just want to re-crit your monkey Grigri. And we're now on Apatol, the monkey. From here you just want to make your way back to the main gate. Want to head east back to King Awawaki, or however it's pronounced, so you can just head through the center of the town. Speak to the elder guard, stood in the doorway. And he'll let you through. And then you can go speak to the king monkey. Now from here you can head out and speak to Garkul. Have to go through this bit of cutscene. Chapter 4, the final battle. Speak to Garkul again. Quick procedure when you're ready for the fight, and you'll be teleported to the area. You have to fight a level 195 jungle demon. I believe it uses mage. Let's go. Screw you, jungle demon. I'm not gonna lie, when he hit me for that 30, I was worried. But this prayer has just made it so much easier. If you're a low level, you could use like a cannon or something. Get my adding bolts work. Speak to Garkul again. Yeah, we need to speak to Zooknock, and he'll take us back to King Narnode. think,
gonna teleport from Spirit Tree back.
It's definitely the longest quest we've done so far. Oh, I know it is. But we're getting there. It's cool.
Three quest points, 10,000 coins, and three diamonds.
So that might seem like a pretty terrible quest reward for such a long quest, but we also get the ability to use dragon scimitars, I believe. But there's also one other thing. If you just climb up to first floor and come speak to Dayro again, you can collect your XP reward from your 10th squad training. You can choose either strength and stamina or attack and defense. The one that you choose, you get 35,000 XP in each, and then I believe you get 20,000 of each in the other, but I'm going to go attack and defense. Several hours mid there. Yeah, so I was right. We're getting, you gain 35,000 experience in the skill that you, the two skills that you choose, and then and 20,000 in the other. So I just got 20,000 strength experience, 20,000 HP XP, 35,000 attack and defense experience. I hope you guys enjoyed this guide, and I'll see you all in the next one. Peace.